Hi, everybody. I just updated my charts with data for August. So let's look at those for Scottsdale and see what's happening to prices. Basically, I'll cut to the conclusion right now is the prices are flat or trending lower in most of Scottsdale, except for Southern Scottsdale. They're still headed up. But that's kind of what you would expect. Seasonally, they would tend to weaken in the fall. So let's dive into it and look at individual zip codes. Let's start in the northernmost northern part of Scottsdale, 85262. And that includes Desert Mountain, Mirabel, Legend Trail, True North, Estancia. So you can see that it's been weak the last couple of months. There's a pretty strong upward trend, obviously. We don't have enough data to know what's going to happen because it would tend to weaken in the spring, in the fall. And but last fall you saw we got some really strong, that strong December number was, which happened, which was typical throughout Scottsdale and throughout Phoenix, was a sign that we're going to have a really strong spring, and we did. And it was unexpected that it would increase in the fall. Typically, it would be flat or weak in the fall. The next zip code down is 85266, which is the Boulder, Cerro Viejo, Whisper Rock, Cinco Dados, Bella Serra. Here, there's obviously no upward movement since April. And then below that is 85255, which is a huge zip code. It includes Greyhawk, McDowell Mountain Ranch, DC Ranch, Silverleaf, Troon. You see the peak there was in May, and it's been kind of down. But then again, if you look at last year at the same time, it peaked in June, and it was kind of lower, and then it took off again. And then below that is 85254, which is really mainly in Phoenix, but still, it was an ex lot. Less inexpensive, a lot more inexpensive than other areas of Scottsdale, although I said most of it is in Phoenix. It's at 176 a square foot, and it's headed up steeply still. I think that trend is strong. And then 260 is in, this is sort of like the Scottsdale Air Park area. No upward momentum at this point. 259 is like Eastern Scottsdale. Like Ancala, Scottsdale Mountain, Stonegate, maybe a little upper. It's kind of mark in time flat. And 258, McCormick Ranch, Gainey Ranch, Scottsdale Ranch. That's definitely no upward momentum there. It's been kind of flat since last December, as far as the median home price for single family homes, that are bought by non-businesses. And then after that, it gets weird. So then after that is 85250, which has got a strong, it's a small zip code, and it still looks really strong. I think it's too high there. I would expect this to not, that's going to be hard to beat, 199 there. Even next year, that could be a peak. That seems unusual to me. 85251 is a weird zip code because part of it, a lot of it, is in Arcadia. So the numbers are all over the place. If that median home, that middle home, is in Arcadia, the prices are super high. And the next month, if that median home is not in Arcadia, prices are much lower. So the prices jump all over the place, and you can see that in here. It's hard to tell. Really, if you're going to analyze a home in this area, the zip code isn't enough. You need to break it down to all of Arcadia, for example, or all of the zip code without Arcadia. And then 85257 is the southernmost zip code, and it's still very, very strong upward trend there. Look at this, it was at one like 189 and not that long ago, and now it's at 152. Huge, huge increase on percentage basis. There's other ones like Paradise Valley 85253 that has the same thing where there's lots of more inexpensive homes and expensive homes, so that's all over the place. I think that has potential to go up. Just looking at it and where prices were here, I would say PV has a lot of upward potential. It was one of the last to really start moving up. And how about Fountain Hills? Fountain Hills, kind of like 85258, kind of mark in time, kind of flat. Oh, let me look at Cave Creek. Cave Creek is really interesting. Cave Creek is like incredibly flat since February. Very, very flat. No upward momentum on prices for the median home price in Cave Creek. Great. So hopefully you found that useful. Hopefully that wasn't too boring for you, but to go over it. But if you want a quick analysis of what's going on in Scottsdale, that gives you a feel for it. It's going to be really cool to feel see what happens this fall. Are they going to go up unexpectedly, at least for me, unexpectedly, like they did go up last fall, particularly November, December? I expect last fall, didn't happen. I expected this fall, the prices will be weaker then. But we'll see. Other videos I have, I expect inventory to go up a lot, which will keep prices down. But I don't expect the prices to go down. I expect the increases in prices to go way down. So we'll just have much, much smaller increases in prices. Great. If you have any questions about homes in Scottsdale, please give me a call. And if you're looking at this on YouTube, please subscribe. I'd appreciate that. Or you can check it on my website, ScottsdaleHomesAsia.com. Please give me a call if you have any questions about buying or selling real estate. I'd appreciate it. Take care. John Wake with HomeSmart. Take care.